baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights in here, baby. You know what I need, want you to see everything. Want you to see all of the lights.
Every day, Princeton University uses a lot of energy. Buildings use anywhere from the 22,000 kilowatt hours needed in Dill and Jim each week to the whopping 200,000 kilowatt hours the engineering departments use in the same time span. But Pacific buildings are only the beginning. Whenever students turn on lights, listen to music, charge their cell phones or laptops, all of this uses power. So how much total energy is needed? In the course of a year, Princeton uses over 145 million kilowatt hours. That's enough to power three quarters of Lesotho, a country with over 2 million people. Obviously, all this power has to come from somewhere, and at Princeton, that spot is right on campus at the cogeneration plant. But what's inside that plant may surprise you.
Oh, yeah!
That's right. Princeton is powered by a jet engine. In order to understand how that's possible, we visited the campus cogeneration plant and talked with the head plant manager, Ted Bolt, who let us see the engine in person.
The gas turbine is General Electric's LM1600. It takes two of these engines, supports the stealth fighter from the F-18 from the air. In our case, we use one engine to make all the heat and all the power for 12,000 people on a day like today. From an airplane, two-thirds of the energy that the airplane carries with it is wasted as lost heat. In our case, we can attach a boiler to the back of the engine. We use that hot exhaust gas to heat up water to make steam to heat the campus or to turn the chillers that are used to cool the campus in the summer. In our case, that fairly inefficient engine, when we couple it with a boiler and do extra work to recover the lost heat, rather than a 30% efficient machine, we have an overall 70 or 80% work system.
The cogeneration plant accounts for 85% of the university's greenhouse gas emissions. Luckily, the jet engine is extremely efficient and drastically reduces the carbon emissions the school produces. With the newly installed steam turbines, the plant is able to produce energy out of what otherwise would have been waste. Bohr and his team expect this equipment to save up to 1,200 tons of carbon dioxide every year. In addition, the plant developed a heat exchanger in 2009.
This new equipment diverts about two-thirds of the exhaust gas to another heat exchanger, and we pull out a lot more heat. Put that heat into the water that comes into the plant to preheat it. That's what helped us bring us up above 60, even 70%, close to 80% efficient. It will help us avoid more than 5,000 tons of CO2 in our emissions each year. This plant is really almost a living organism. We are not at all static. Like, we didn't just buy the plant and keep it going exactly as we bought it. We're constantly looking for, all right, what's the next layer of improvement that we can do? Should we insulate more? How can we continue to save money? How can we continue to reduce our environmental footprint?
As Bohrer has mentioned, the cogen plant has played an important role in reducing Princeton's carbon footprint. While we still emit over 110,000 metric tons of carbon a year, a lot has been done to lower this number. The engineers at the plant started with an engine that was approximately 30% efficient. With things such as heat recovery and steam turbines, we have been able to reduce this number by almost 10,000 metric tons and create an environment in which the engine is almost 80% efficient. With these types of innovations, Princeton is able to set itself apart as a leader in sustainable development.